There's an area down south of Victoria where green hills tumble through pristine air and onto endless deserted ocean beaches. It's green, it's fertile, it's damp, and it's beautiful. Four words which, when blended masterfully together, become a bullseye for agriculture, food, booze, produce, accommodation, and design. This is where God spanked the landscape on the bottom with a rainbow. You may have only heard of Gippsland because of the bushfires, but welcome to it. A beautiful place for a magnificent drive. The Gippsland region stretches from Melbourne's eastern outskirts right up to the New South Wales border. Our self-made food and wine trail begins in Inverloch, where husband and wife team Marcus Satchell and Lisa Sartori have found themselves the perfect place to produce the perfect drop.
It really is all about the place and where the wine's grown, and we've got three different sites that we grow that Pinot Noir in. Okay. And so hence the three different dirts, the Dirty Three.
While they dabble in a few varieties, their signature wine is Pinot Noir.
This is from dirt number one, which we call this called Berry's Creek. That's the most furthest north, and the furthest away from the coast of the three. It's on deep red volcanic soil and produces a really lovely kind of open and bright, bright fruited wine.
And very delicious.
The thing for me with Pinot Noir is, and it took me a while to appreciate Pinot Noir, you have to find a silky one, don't you? It's got to be satiny and seductive.
Yeah, I think that's part of the allure, and really for me that's what Pinot is. It's that satiny, beautiful, velvety character and
sensuality.
Correct.
It's a sexy wine.
It is a sexy wine.
A 20-minute drive north through Gippsland's green rolling hills delivers us to the cellar door and production headquarters of Prom Country Cheese. The focus here is on producing cheese from sheep's milk, raised and bred on site.
How does it differ from cow's cheese?
Well, sheep milk has a very high level of cream and also protein and minerals. And that extra cream helps with the texture of the cheese as well.
Set against the lush landscape of their purpose-built dairy in Moyarra, the Brandons make some of the best cheese in the country.
Now, this one is the Venus Blue. I know this is a famous cheese, isn't it? You've won lots of awards with this cheese.
Yeah, it's sort of becoming by default our signature cheese. Everything comes together, and it's pretty reliable result with it.
It's got that great blue cheese bite that I love. It's not a big, overpowering blue cheese bite. There's plenty there, but it's not overpowering.
Gippsland is full of tiny towns that are home to master craftsmen of all trades.
Up here is a classic example of the quietly evolving, changing face of this part of the world. And there it is just there.
Once a small dairy farm, Ross Farm is the product of a genius transformation by a father and daughter duo who took three existing but dilapidated buildings and converted them into three unique and inspiring properties, suitably named The Cabin, The Barn and The Dairy.
Oh yeah, it's all class. It's recycled, repurposed, reimagined, re-engineered and just elegant. This is the kind of place you want to take home with you.
Preserving the agricultural architecture was the driving force behind the restoration. There is a very cool design consciousness going on around here, such that it even permeates the immediate environment. Look. The lemons have fallen artistically from the tree. Another meandering half-hour drive from Ross Farm is the delightful little town of Lock.
Lock is the quintessential glorious Australian country town with the cleanest of air and the freshest of water. Two ingredients you'd think would be essential when it comes to brewing and distilling. Well, they ain't. All that process requires really is alcohol, flavour,
master craftsman. Housed in a century-old red brick former bank, Lock Brewery and Distillery was originally a whisky-making venture, but there's been a couple of intoxicating detours along the way.
Originally, the love was just for whisky, and then really we discovered that to make good whisky, you have to have a good beer, have to have 90% of the kit. Why not make beer as well?
And while waiting for the whisky to age, they introduced a gin, which quickly turned into a whole range of gins.
I don't even need to drink that. I can smell that is beautiful.
You can definitely smell it. It's, it makes a very, very nice martini as well. It warms the cockles of your heart.
Absolutely. That's beautiful.